What's up, guys? I'm hunched down here in a bed of poison ivy next to this little ditch after work. We're getting ready to fish it. Hopefully we'll catch a few species. I don't know. We're going to be using the super ultralight Indonesian Berkeley rod to microfish this area. Let's see what we catch. All right, guys. So like I was saying in the intro there, we're using Indonesian Berkeley rod. These rods are made out of fiber optic line from telephone lines and internet cable. They're extremely flexible. I like to call it super ultralight micro fishing. Let me see if I can do this without getting tangled up. I'll show you guys just exactly what these rods can do. You start up here at the top, bend it there, reach down, grab the bottom handle. And you can double these rods over themselves about three times. And then they just kind of flop back out in their original form. Super fun to use. I'll leave links under the video to them. Make sure you guys get your hands on these rods. They're just good fun. You know, it's kind of interesting to get in these little ditches and see what's in there, you know. You never know what you're going to catch. There's species that, you know, a lot of people don't even know exist because they don't pay attention to them. So get out there and explore your local ditch. Give it a shot. Let's get to fishing. I'm going to start in this hole right here. We're going to be using red worms. A little tiny piece of red worm for bait. So just reach down in there. Pinch off the end of one of these with my manly fingernails. Nope. I let him escape. And I dropped my piece of worm. Where'd it go? Yeah, I lost a piece of worm. Sorry, buddy. I'm about to pinch you again. Oh, Lord. This is starting out horribly. Okay. Now, as long as I can keep hold of this tiny piece of worm, yeah, we'll be able to start fishing. The hooks are kind of hard to bait because they're so tiny, but it's not too bad. Reach down in that good old pile of poison ivy right there. Take the rubber band off of my spool. I already got a bite. Yep, fish on. Here we go. First fish of the day. Let's look, see what we got here. Let's see what we got. See what we got. The first species is a bluegill. I'll put him in the photo tank for you guys. We'll get a little shot of him. Why not? Might as well. Alright. Bluegills matter too. Well, he's a little too big to fit in the photo tank, so We'll just let him go. Awesome, little tiny bluegill. I'm going to be getting in the water today. Hoping to find maybe some darter species or something. I'm really, really, really trying to catch some darters. And I'm having a difficult time with it. Thinking back on that little stick again. Nope, fish on. Looks like a creek chub, second species. Creek chub, right on. Holy crap. Whoa, dude. Oh, he came off. That's a bluegill. He took off. He's like, holy crap. Something stabbed me. This is where I caught my first stone roller, actually. In this very spot. There's still fish down there. Took my worm on that one. I see why I'm not hooking fish very good. Well, my hook got snagged on my tackle bag. It bent the shank of the hook upward. These things are so fragile, man. I think it'll be all right. There we go, fish on. I think that's another bluegill because he's like super freaking out. Bluegill do that for some reason. It is a bluegill.
It's a little tiny bluegill. Look at it.
Another one. What we got here? Green sunfish, third species. Little green sunfish. So we've caught green sunfish, creek chub, and bluegill so far. Holy crap, dude. Another bluegill. Yep, another bluegill. A little bit smaller than the last one. What the crap, dude? Bluegill again. It's the same fish, man. Same fish, bro. Same fish, bro. Something dragged it over that way. There we go.
Here we go.
There's just a school of bluegill down there, I guess. Don't really want to sit here and catch a bluegill constantly, though. Be honest with you. Uh-oh, okay. Oh, something was following that one. Another bluegill. Yeah, he had something following him. It was a little bit bigger. Probably a bigger bluegill. If I catch another bluegill, I might just move spots. Oh, Jesus. I think it's another bluegill. Yep, it is. Another bluegill. I didn't realize I was down this far. Holy crap. Probably not gonna catch anything up in here now. Try. Oh shoot. Wow, okay. Green sunfish, pretty big one. There's a little creek here. Didn't expect to get anything, you know, since I, you know, just walked through here. At least it wasn't a bluegill, right? I'm still getting bites. Wow. Okay. Not gonna complain. No, he came off. Seen a fish go over there.
He's like, help me. It's Godzilla.
I took off one little sinker. I use tiny little size 10 sinkers. They're that little green speck right there. I was hoping to maybe find some darter species in here or something. Should be a nice little spot right here. Probably bluegill. Holy crap, dude. He nailed it. He's like, give me that worm. crap, dude. I had another one. He didn't fight like, he didn't fight like those other fish did. That was something different, I think. Oh, holy cow. No, it's green sunfish. A lot of green sunfish in here, which is not actually a good thing. They eat a lot of the other fishes. Green sunfish. Oh, dang it, he came off. I don't know what that was. I didn't get a good enough look at him. My hook's still messed up a little bit. From where it got snagged. Shouldn't have any issues cooking stuff though. Can't see where I'm at. Glare. Oh shoot. No. I was gonna try something. I can't walk over in that spot. Okay, good. Probably lost my worm. Nope, I didn't. Sweet. So I was just going to try shaking it over here and dropping it in. At the tree here. Oh crap. Green sunfish. Another pretty decent sized green sunfish for this creek. Not bad at all. What the crap is that? That is a green sunfish too. A very tiny one.
if there's any darter species up in this creek or not. Now look, little water snake. Or gardener snake anyway. You guys see it? Right there. In the water. I know you can see him. I'm not going to bother him. I treat all snakes with as much respect as I can give them, because, you know, I really don't want to get bitten. There's probably one in this tree I'm getting ready to go under. Whatever that is, it's pulling back. I think I have a turtle. I do. I have a freaking turtle. Ah, you gotta be kidding. Oh, that came loose. Good. Whew. Yeah, there's a big snapping turtle right there. Wow. I was like, wait a minute. Whatever this is pulling back. And it's a big snapping turtle. So I doubt there's anything down in here. I can't believe that. Big old snapping turtle. I thought I was snagged. I was like, dude. Whatever I've got is slowly pulling back. Oh, I had a fish. There we go, fish on. Alright, pretty good size. Green sunfish pretty much own this creek, I think. I've seen a snake and a snapping turtle. Oh shoot, he grabbed that quick. Here we are. I think that's gonna be it, guys. My wife's off today. Go home and spend some time with her. You know. can't believe I hooked into a snapping turtle. What in the world? Let's see. Almost forgot how to do my rubber band here.
Guys, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Wasn't too much of a video, but you know, I got out of here and enjoyed myself for a little bit after work in this little tiny ditch. Caught 3 species, so that's pretty good. Again, I'll leave the link to the rods underneath the video. My wife is making her merchandise and stuff now, so if you guys want to get you a shirt or something, I'll leave that link below the video as well. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.